Let us say that these are two busy roads. And now you want to open a shop near these two busy roads. Where will you open that shop? Now, if you want to open a shop, you would definitely want as many customers as possible to come in that shop. So let's say you want to open a shop somewhere here. So where exactly? Now you want as many customers as possible. That means you would want your shop ideally such that it is equidistant from both these roads. From these two busy roads, this shop should be equidistant so that people can come here also and here also equal distance from. So this shop should be equidistant from both these busy roads. Now for that, let us recall angle bisector. Now angle bisector is a line that bisects this angle, which is formed by these two lines. So let us say these two lines are AC and AB, and the angle that is being formed is angle BAC. Now a line that bisects this angle BAC is AE. It is bisecting this angle into two equal angles. So let us say this is also x and this is also x. If this total angle was 2x degrees, now this is x and this is x. So that is AE has divided this angle into two equal parts. So AE becomes the angle bisector. Further, we know that any point on the angle bisector is equidistant from the arms that form the angle. That is, if I take points on this line AE, which is the angle bisector, then it is equidistant. And this is nothing, is equidistant, that is this distance is equal to this. Also, this distance is the perpendicular distance. When we talk of distance from a point to a line, we always talk about the perpendicular distance. We've already studied that. Further, what we see is that this distance is equal to this distance and this distance is equal to this distance. That is, if I take any point on this angle bisector, then I can say that that point would be equidistant from the arms of the angle that it is bisecting. So since it is bisecting angle BAC, the arms are AB and AC. So this point would be equidistant from both the arms, that is from AB and AC. So we've got points which lie on the angle bisector are equidistant from both the arms which form the angle. Now let us try to prove this. So what we are trying to prove is that if a point lies on the angle bisector, it would be equidistant from the arms of that angle. So what we need first is two lines. So we have these two lines and which are forming an angle. So we have an angle BOD. Let's say that this green line here is the line which is bisecting this angle BOD. So what we get is that this angle is equal to this angle, since this green line is the angle bisector of angle BOD. Now what I'm told is that any point that lies on this line, on this green line which is the angle bisector. So let's take a point P that lies on this line which is the angle bisector. Now what I want to prove is that the distance of this point from both these lines, which is OB and OD, would be equal. Distance, by distance I mean the perpendicular distance. Since we are finding the distance of a point from a line, so we have to find the perpendicular distance. So this is what we are given. What we know is that OP is the angle bisector, that is these two angles are equal. Further, what I know is that point P lies on the angle bisector and PN and PM are perpendiculars to OB and OD respectively. So this is what I am given. What I want to prove is that these lines are equidistant. This perpendicular distance, which is the distance, is equal. That is, MP is equal to NP. What I want to prove is MP is equal to NP. So first, let's look at these two triangles here. OMP and triangle ONP. Let me color these two triangles. So let's look at these two triangles now. The first thing that we can observe is that OP is the angle bisector. If this is the angle bisector, then this angle here would be equal to this angle here. That is, angle MOP would be equal to angle NOP in these two triangles. This is what I get. Angle MOP would be equal to NOP. Why? Because P lies on the angle bisector. This is a line which is the angle bisector of this angle, which is BOD. Second thing which you can observe is, let's call this angle 1 and this is angle 2. Now this angle 1 here is equal to angle 2. Both are 90 degrees. Since MP and NP are perpendiculars to OB and OD. So I get angle 1 equals angle 2 because each is 90 degree. MP is perpendicular to OB and NP is perpendicular to OD. So this is what I get. Angle 1 equals angle 2. Now let's look at this. Line OP. OP is common to both the triangles. OP is being shared by triangle OMP also has OP and triangle ONP also has the line OP. So OP is common to both the triangles. So I can say that OP is equal to OP because it is common. Now I have angle MOP equals to angle NOP, angle 1 equals to angle 2 and a side which is OP is equal to OP. Angle, angle, side. Angle, angle, side. So I have two angles, one side, and I can say that these two triangles would be congruent by angle, angle, side. So triangle OMP and triangle ONP. So this triangle, green triangle here, is congruent to the orange triangle here. So triangle OMP is congruent to triangle ONP by angle, angle, side. Now once we know that the triangles are congruent, then the corresponding parts of the congruent triangles are also equal. So I can say MP is the corresponding part here, NP is the corresponding part here. So I can say that MP is equal to NP by CPCT, which means corresponding parts of congruent triangles. So I get that MP is equal to NP, and this is what I wanted to prove. Hence I've proved that if there is a point that lies on the angle bisector, then that point would be equidistant from the arms of the angle that it is bisecting. Now let's try to look at the converse. By converse I mean that if there is a point which is equidistant from two lines, then that point should lie on the angle bisector. So conversely, I can say if there is a point which is equidistant from two intersecting lines, then that point lies on a straight line which bisects the angle between those two lines. So let us say we have these two lines. What we know is that there is a point which is equidistant from both these lines. So let us have a point here, P, which is equidistant from both these lines. By equidistant, I mean that the distance is equal from this point to this line. And when we talk of the distance of a point to a line, we talk about the perpendicular distance. So these are the two perpendiculars. And we are saying that these perpendicular distances, that is distance of P to the line OB and distance of P to the line OD. So PM is equal to PN. This is what we are given. We are given that MP and NP are equal. We are given that PM is perpendicular to OB and PN is perpendicular to OD. This is what we are given. What I want to prove is that P lies on the angle bisector. That is, P lies on the angle bisector of angle BOD. So what I want to prove is that P lies on the angle bisector of angle BOD. For that, what I'll do is, let me join this line, joining points O and P. So I draw a line joining O and P. Now let's look at these two triangles here. That is triangle OMP and triangle ONP. Let me color these two triangles. So we look at these two triangles here now. What I know is that MP is equal to NP. This is given to me. MP is equal to NP, given to me. This is the first condition which I know. Now the second thing which I know is that PM is perpendicular to OB and PN is perpendicular to OD. Since they are perpendicular, it's forming a 90 degree angle here. So I can say that this angle 1 here is equal to angle 2. What I get is angle 1 is equal to angle 2 because each is 90 degrees. MP is perpendicular to OB and NP is perpendicular to OD. This is my second condition now. Now the third condition is that OP is equal to OP. OP is common in both these triangles. So I can say that OP is equal to OP, which is common. Now I have three conditions here. A right angle, one side and the hypotenuse. The side opposite to the right angle, the hypotenuse. So right angle, side and hypotenuse. Right angle, side and hypotenuse. So I can say that triangle OMP is congruent to triangle ONP by right angle, hypotenuse, side, which is by RHS. So these two triangles are congruent by RHS. If the triangles are congruent, then the corresponding parts of the congruent triangles are also congruent. So I have these two triangles that are congruent. Now corresponding parts of these two triangles should be congruent. That means the corresponding sides and the corresponding angles would be equal. Now these two triangles have this as the corresponding angle, which is angle MOP and angle NOP. What I can say is that angle MOP would be equal to angle NOP, corresponding angle CPCT. But angle MOP is equal to angle BOP. So this is nothing but angle BOP, which is equal to angle NOP, is nothing but equal to angle DOP. So instead of angle NOP, I can write angle DOP. So this is what I get, that angle BOP is equal to angle POD. So angle BOP is equal to angle POD. Since these two angles are equal here, what I can say is that OP is the angle bisector. It is bisecting this angle here. Angle BOD is being bisected by OP. So P lies on the angle bisector. So I can say that P lies on the bisector of angle BOD. Hence I am done with my proof. This is what I wanted to prove. So what I have seen is that if there are two lines and there is a point which is equidistant from both these lines, then that point will lie on the angle bisector. So I have these two lines and I wanted points which are equidistant from both these lines. So locus of all such points would be nothing but the angle bisector of the angle that these two lines are forming. So these two lines are forming this angle. This is the angle bisector of this angle. So locus of all points equidistant from these two lines gives me this line, which is the bisector of the angle which is being formed by the two lines. Now if you carefully observe, then these two lines on intersection are forming another angle, which is here. This is also another angle that is being formed. Now, if I want points that are equidistant from both these lines, then it would be again be the angle bisector. We've already seen angle bisector. We've already seen the angle bisector gives us all points equidistant from two lines. So what I see is if I extend this line backwards, now this line gives me any point on this line would be equidistant from points on this line would be equidistant from these two lines, and points on this line, which is the angle bisector of this, would be equidistant from these two lines. Now, with these two angles, there are two more angles that are being formed. That is this angle and this angle. So similarly, what I can say is, for this angle, this is the locus of all such points equidistant from these two blue lines. That is the angle bisector of this angle. So this is the angle which is being formed by these two lines here. And this red line is the angle bisector of this line. So this is all the points, this gives me all the points that are equidistant from these two lines. Similarly, I get the fourth angle, and this is the angle bisector of this fourth angle. Now all points on this line give me points which are equidistant from these two lines. So this is the angle bisector. Any point on this line would be equidistant from this line and this line. So what you can see is that when you have a pair of intersecting lines, the locus of points which are equidistant from these intersecting lines would be nothing but a pair of lines which are the bisectors of angles which these lines are forming. So these lines are forming four angles, 1, 2, 3, 4. So you find all the bisectors of these angles, which is these four red lines. And you would see that these four red lines are nothing but intersecting lines, a pair of intersecting lines, which are angle bisectors of angles which are being formed by these lines L1 and L2. So this is the locus of such points. Remember, when you have two fixed points and you want to find point which is equidistant from those two fixed points, then you look at perpendicular bisector. But when you have two fixed lines and you want points that are equidistant from those two lines, then remember that we are talking about angle bisector.